Hi, welcome back to the last segment of this particular episode of Ask the Expert with Dr. Stephen Katznelson, the medical director of the kidney transplant program here at the California Pacific Medical Center. This particular segment, we will be talking about some of the coming changes in the kidney allocation rules. So let me turn it over to Dr. Katznelson. Could you give us a little broad overview about this change that is, I understand it, about to happen?
Sure. For years, UNOS, mm-hmm. United Network for Organ Sharing, has been looking at the allocation system presently used and trying to make it better.
Mm-hmm.
The reason for making it better is to make it fairer, number one.
Okay.
And number two, to try to take the scarce resource, which is a deceased donor kidney, mm-hmm. and try to make the best use of it.
Right.
For somewhere between 8 and 10 years, the older allocation system has been remodeled, looked at mathematically, looked at by anywhere from mathematicians to scientists and philosophers, mm-hmm. to try to figure out a better way to use each kidney that's being donated in this country. So the new allocation system is in part devised to make things more fair.
Mm-hmm.
There's another problem in different parts of the country. I'm happy to say not so much in the San Francisco Bay Area, mm-hmm. but in some parts of the country, patients are referred for kidney transplant very late in the course of their dialysis. I mean, we've had patients referred to us who have never seen a transplant center before, who have been in dialysis, say, for 10 years.
Oh, my goodness.
The way the current national system works is the time when you are referred for transplant center, they put you on the waiting list, that's when your waiting time starts.
Mm-hmm.
So patients who have not had the benefit of a good early referral,
mm-hmm.
lose all that time on the waiting list, and even if they've been on dialysis for 10 years, their waiting time starts after that.
Mm-hmm.
And that has unfairly affected people who come from areas with poor referral patterns.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the new rules that will be rolling out probably in the fourth quarter of 2014 and likely in the second half of December will be that the starting time on the waiting list is going to be measured back to the start time in dialysis.
Interesting.
So what it does is it takes care of those patients who are referred late,
mm-hmm.
and that's deemed to be fair, and I would agree. Another piece to this,
mm-hmm.
is trying to make the best use of each kidney that is allocated. For example, and these are all deceased donor kidney transplants.
Okay.
We're no longer talking about live donation.
Right.
This
okay.
is all about deceased donor kidney transplants. Kidneys, as an example, kidneys from donors who are much older,
mm-hmm.
tend to have a shorter lifespan. So in general terms, if you were to take a kidney out of a 80-year-old deceased donor,
mm-hmm.
which is rarely done, so let's use 70, a 7-year-old
right.
deceased donor, that kidney has already some wear and tear on it,
mm-hmm.
because it's been in a person's body for a long time and might only last a handful of years in a recipient.
Mm-hmm.
It would seem to be unfair to take that 70-year-old kidney and put it in a 20-year-old individual.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it's even fair to put that kidney into a 40-year-old individual because it might only last a handful of years in that individual.
Mm-hmm.
On the flip side, take a horrible story of a 20-year-old drowning victim,
mm-hmm.
a deceased donor who's 20 years old, and that person was healthy until they drowned,
mm-hmm.
But their kidneys, their organs are fine. If you took that kidney and put it in a 20-year-old, that kidney could go on and last dozens of years.
Mm-hmm.
If you took that kidney and put it in a 75-year-old,
mm-hmm.
the kidney could last for dozens of years, but a 75-year-old doesn't last for dozens of years.
Right.
And so really wouldn't be using that resource well.
Mm-hmm.
And with the current allocation system, it does allow for this type of mismatch,
mm-hmm.
between qualities of the donor and qualities of the recipient. So the general thrust of this new allocation change then is to try to get the most years of every kidney allocated. And by changing the allocation system in these ways,
mm-hmm.
The mathematical modeling tells us that once the system rolls out, in general, there will be thousands of extra kidney life years,
mm-hmm. kidney
injected life into the recipient population.
Kidney life years, as in the number of years that a kidney is active in helping a patient survive.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right. For example, if I might go back to my example, putting a 20-year-old kidney into a 20-year-old might have 40 years of kidney life added to added to the population of that recipient specifically.
Mm-hmm.
Taking that 20-year-old kidney and putting it in a 75-year-old, that kidney might only be used
mm-hmm.
for 5 or 10 years. That's many fewer life years to that kidney.
Right, right. Okay. And so this obviously has been in discussion for a long time then, right?
Yes.
And you were saying this is all kinds of people involved, everybody from physicians to medical ethicists. So this is purely like a UNOS? This is done at UNOS?
Yes. So this is very much a national change.
Okay.
This is not a change that any transplant center
mm-hmm.
or any transplant locale or region has a choice about.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to roll out and probably in December of 2014.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are choices that patients can make and choices that the transplant centers can make within these general rule structures.
I see.
And those of us who run kidney transplant programs are going to be working over the next several months to try to incorporate the changes in the way that benefits our patient population the best.
Okay. Just to be clear, we said this is a national change, but it's not a legal change, right? This is just how the organizations that manage, UNOS in this case, that manage the kidney donation, they've kind of gotten together to make this.
That's true. So I don't think it is
a law, okay.
But it acts like the law because once the switch is flipped,
mm-hmm.
Allocation will this new rollout will occur
mm-hmm.
in the United States.
Okay. So now, obviously, for people who are not on the list yet, this will be new to them.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously, for someone who's been on the waiting list, how would this affect them? Obviously, this is probably on a highly individualized basis, but what are your thoughts on that?
So that's the best question,
mm-hmm.
So when we're talking about a broadly applied rule, how does it affect the individual?
Mm-hmm.
And the answer to that question, and this has been part of the mathematical modeling, is when I'm sitting and talking to a patient, what do I answer when they say, what is this going to do to me in my place in
mm-hmm.
the waiting? It's a very valid question. And the answer to it is, for any individual person, there's very little movement
mm-hmm.
on the waiting list.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at the whole pool in the United States, people won't, on the average, gain a lot of waiting time or lose a lot of the waiting time. There will be individuals who gain a fair amount of waiting time. For example, the patient who had 10 years of dialysis
mm-hmm.
and just got referred, that 10 years would count, and I think most of us would think that that's fair.
Mm-hmm.
But on the average, the movement for any one person is really quite small.
Mm-hmm.
People won't feel that, especially in an area here where the waiting times are already fairly long.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So individually, it's kind of hard to say, but because there's so many people, the changes will be very incremental.
Exactly.
Where would a person go to find out more details about these rules?
So the best place for information will be to the UNOS website.
Mm-hmm.
And if I'm not mistaken, many of the patient materials are still being formulated
okay.
and may not be available, I believe, until April.
Okay.
Though there's already plenty of things to read on the web about the allocation changes, and then each transplant center will be disseminating information to their patient population as to how to negotiate it, what they need to do, what they don't need to do,
okay.
And things they should be thinking about.
Okay. So for our viewers who are out there, we will be posting the link to the UNOS website to go along with this video. So that you can inform yourself about this upcoming change. Of course, as Dr. Katznelson said, it isn't final yet. As it is now mid-March of 2014. There'll be more information coming out in April, and it won't go into effect, if I understood correctly, towards the end of 2014.
That's true.
Okay.
And there may, though, be some interaction between transplant centers and individuals on the waiting list.
Mm-hmm.
For example, there's a category of deceased donor transplants now called ECD, or expanded criteria donor transplants. These are generally kidneys from older donors, and patients who are interested in ECD transplants,
mm-hmm.
which have a shorter waiting time,
okay.
have to sign a consent form to enter the ECD list. The consent form is going to change because the term ECD is no longer going to be applied, but there will be another term applied to it. So UNOS is saying that we have to change our consent forms to mirror this change.
Mm-hmm.
So there will be that kind of communication. But we, as other transplant programs, will be very explicit about
mm-hmm.
what it is that they're signing and what it means as far as transplant availability.
So ECD, or expanded criteria donors, these are older donors?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They tend to be, okay, all right.
Yeah, and that distinction will go away.
I see.
And be replaced by KDPI greater than 85. We'll talk about that another time.
Okay, all right. Well, this has been very informative. Thank you, Dr. Katznelson, for taking the time to be with us. That's all for today. And again, we really appreciate Dr. Katznelson for his time on all of these very interesting topics. I hope you found this educational. And we look forward to the next time when we bring you another episode of Ask the Expert with the Bay Area Association of Kidney Patients. Thank you.